If you're passionate about design and want to see how ideas become products, you have come to the right place. My name is Lautaro, and as an industrial designer, I will guide you through the process of creating a unique desk clock from the concept to the final manufactured product. I hope you enjoy the video, and let's jump right in. For this project, I have been designing a minimalist desk clock made up of the main body and the frame that allows you to adjust the angle of the clock to face directly toward the user. The frame also serves as a handle, and these two pieces create a beautiful contrast in shape, material, and color. So once we have a rough idea about the design, it's time to start the 3D modeling. I will be using the iPad version of Shaper 3D first, and once the design is tested, I will switch to the desktop version to finalize the design for manufacturing and create technical drawings. The latest version of Shaper 3D has a very useful feature called history-based parametric modeling. This feature allows you to access and modify your design history, enabling you to adjust the design parameters later on, so you can refine your work without starting from scratch. Since I will be 3D printing prototypes, it is important to account for all the tolerances between parts to avoid assembly issues. To check these tolerances, we can use the section view feature, which lets you to see how the parts fit together and ensure everything is aligned properly. Before modeling the internal components, I want to make sure that the clock looks exactly as I imagine it, so I will use the visualization tool to test different wood finishes for the body and the frame. Once I'm happy with the look, I will move on to the internal parts. The design includes two internal pins that will act as hinges, allowing the clock's head to rotate fully so the user can change its angle. These pins fit securely with a press fit and shape lock, ensuring they stay in place without slipping. The back cover we have 4 holes for screws, so it is important to measure everything accurately to ensure the screws fit perfectly and keep everything in place. Finally, I will add a knob to the design, which will be used to set the time on the clock. The next step is to test the mechanism and make any final improvements to prepare the design for manufacturing. Thanks to the careful consideration of tolerances during the modeling process, the pieces fit together perfectly, eliminating the need to revise and reprint the design. Okay, everything is working as expected, so it's time to prepare the design to send to our trusted supplier. I will be testing different solid woods, so it is essential to provide all the detailed information to ensure clear communication with the manufacturing supplier. Once the samples arrive, it's time to review them and assemble the final prototypes. The woods I have used for these samples are maple, cherry, and walnut. The finish is a natural oil finish, giving the wood a smooth, elegant look. And this is how the final prototype have turned out, all ready to be used and enjoyed. I hope you find this video helpful, and if you have any question, feel free to reach out. I'm always happy to help. Happy modeling, and see you in the next video.